What's up, everybody? PJ Braun, president of Blackstone Labs and Prime Nutrition. You guys are about to watch the first training video that I have done in a couple years. Since I retired from competitive bodybuilding, I've been doing well with my Beat PJ transformation challenge. And I was feeling pretty good, had a little bit of a carb up on Sunday. And so I decided I was looking slightly like a bodybuilder again. Maybe I'll show you guys the way I've been training these days. But before you see this video, I'm gonna get into some of the products that I'm using. I never bullshit you guys, so I'm gonna tell you the truth. I'm not using any of the pro hormones right now from Blackstone Labs. But some of the things that I do use regularly are EAAs, watermelon. I like the watermelon a little more than the kiwi strawberry, although they're both good. I do 5 scoops of this in my gallon of water every day. I drink the most of my water during my workout. I drink probably a good half a gallon to 2/3 of a gallon on a leg day, maybe even 3/4 of a gallon just during my workout. The rest of the water that I drink a day, if I shoot for more than a gallon, 1.5 gallons, whatever, it usually won't have the EAAs in it. Now you're gonna say, oh, PJ, that's so expensive to use that many EAAs, and it is, actually. But you don't have to do such a high amount like I do. You can get away with one or two, as long as you're pounding it during your workout, for sure. I think for women, one is great. For guys, you're probably gonna wanna do at least two. The more you can do, the better. This is something that I think is really awesome about the John Meadows product, the Intra MD, because there's 13 grams of aminos in that. So you're getting the highly branched cyclic dextrin and you're getting the high concentration of aminos. You're getting two products together in one. Why am I not using the Intra MD right now? Because I'm on a ketogenic diet, or an Atkins style diet, perhaps you wanna call it, and I simply just can't have those carbs right now. I'm very excited to get back onto that product because I have been a little more sore since I have not been using it, but I am a very, very big advocate of high dose amino acids, and if you're doing 5 scoops of this, you're getting 25 grams in your gallon. So let's get that out of the way. The other two, Blackstone Labs Hype and Prime Nutrition PWO Stim. You guys are probably gonna be like, why aren't you taking angel dust? Here's the thing, now that I've gotten a little bit older, I can't handle all the stims anymore. Angel dust is crazy, and if I'm brutally exhausted, I'll have some angel dust, but for the most part, I really, really don't like that crazy stim, cracked out feeling that I used to when I was younger. I find that 2 scoops of PWO Stim and 2 scoops of Hype together, shotgunned with like 5 ounces of water right before I walk into the gym, I get unbelievable pumps. It's just enough of a stim, like caffeine, like blast to wake me up a little bit. And that's all I need. I'm really more focused on the pump these days. Both flavors of this one are good. I alternate them all the time. I prefer the lemon lime PWO Stim over the grape, and it mixes well with the orange. And that's it. Hope you guys enjoy the video. I'm gonna try to make it as instructional as possible, and maybe we'll do some more of these. All right, guys, a couple of things. Number one, I'm showing the clock because I want you to see the pace that I go and how fast it takes me. I don't like hearing people say that they don't have time to work out. And this is my warm-ups included. So all my sets that I do, warm-ups included. Number two, that is my MRI results. Now, many of you know that I blew my shoulder out a couple times. Most recently, the MRI results that I have showed 7 things wrong with my shoulder, including 2 separations. The AC joint was separated, and I also had a glenoid dysplasia, which is apparently pretty sucky and rare. But thanks to Dr. Nick Ruggiero, who my buddy Flex Lewis got me into seeing, I'm actually able to train pretty hard again. I'm really, really smart with what I do. I do a lot of warm-ups, and I don't do exercises that cause me any pain, but I literally couldn't train any shoulders at all. Very limited chest, very limited arms, and now I can pretty much do everything again, so I'm really, really happy. We're gonna take you through a sample chest workout. Now, I go very fast. I don't take many breaks. So what you're seeing here is basically 2, maybe 3 sets we're gonna show, working sets of each exercise that I do. But I'm gonna do typically 4 working sets per exercise. So we're not gonna show you all that. It'll be a very boring video. I start out with the Smith Machine incline press. I try to go a little heavier on there. When I first started, I couldn't do 135. In about 6 weeks, I'm up to doing 275, pretty controlled. I don't push it past pain on there anymore. I hit what I feel is close to failure, but not failure. Now you're gonna see me super setting the hammer strength incline and in hammer strength upright press. I really like both of these machines. I do a lot of supersetting with my training now. I don't do too much heavy compound stuff anymore. It's a lot of volume, a lot of reps. I like to get as much blood flowing as possible. My philosophy is that if you force a dramatic amount of blood into the muscle. It has no choice but to grow. And that's also why I go such short rest periods. I don't like to give the muscle time to recover. I like to keep the blood flow in there. You'll also notice when I finish a lot of my sets and I hunch over looking like I'm in pain, which sometimes I am a little bit, I'm actually contracting my chest really, really hard, making sure that I keep the tension on the muscle. This is something that I do for all my body parts, not just chest. But my style of training has differed, over the years. But what I do now, I find is best for injury prevention. It's best for maximizing pump, and it's best for maximizing time in the gym. And I do think this is an effective way for everybody to train. Moving on here, another superset that I'll be doing. I like to superset the pec deck with the flat hammer strength chest press. Now, I don't do a lot of flat work. In this particular workout, I did a little bit more than normal. I usually focus about 90% of my exercises around incline movements. I do like to mix in some flat stuff from time to time just to mix it up. I think that everything is good sometimes, but nothing works all the time, so variety is key. You'll see me running over here to use this chest machine. Some of you may say that my form is a little sloppy here. I'm doing it like this on purpose. I believe more in the stretch at the bottom. I think that's what's most important than locking out at the top. Also, when I lock out, it bothers my shoulder. And I have very, very overpowering triceps, so I try to not lock out and put the stress on my triceps either. I'm really just going for as much burn as possible. And when you've been moving as fast as I move, which anybody that trains with me usually can't stand, you'll see that the pump and the blood flow gets excruciatingly bad. It's a painful burn. It's a deep burn, so deep, but it's painful. So I think we're only gonna show a couple sets of this. Nobody wants to sit and see me on the pec deck all day. But again, I wanted you guys to get a feel for the exercise selection I use, the way that I put it together in my workouts. Lots of volume, lots of reps. Usually don't go less than 10 or 12 reps on anything. It may go as high as 20 on a lot of exercises. And as I've said, I'll keep reiterating, very, very short rest periods. Running back over here. Again, I want you to notice that I put 25-pound plates underneath the top of this machine. So it's actually at a very, very slight incline, maybe 15% incline, which I think is just enough to actually put the stress a little bit more through your upper chest and make it a little bit safer. The flat exercises are a little bit more dangerous on my shoulder. Now that I have it feeling good, I don't want to make it worse again. I'm trying to avoid surgery. I'm probably going to be doing some PRP injections, which you guys can Google that and look into it. It's pretty revolutionary new medicine. I'd much rather do that than get hacked open. Then I moved on to incline dumbbell press. This is probably my favorite exercise. I do it later in the workouts now. I used to start my workouts with this and go very heavy, but I actually was doing this exercise when I hurt my shoulder in one of the more recent injuries, so now I like to do it later on when I'm more fatigued. This way I really can't go more than maybe 90, 100 pounds on dumbbells, where when I do it fresh, I can do 130, 140 for a very good amount of reps. Looks like I decided to take off my hoodie here, show you guys what I look like a little bit. So it's the first time I've shown what I look like since the start of the Beat PJ transformation. I'm a little carbed up here. I did a carb up on Sunday. This is a Tuesday workout, so I'm a little more full than normal. But you can see my separation starting to come out and my legs and calves here. Hitting a few shots in the mirror. Now, this is not just vanity. And checking myself out. This is actually part of my workout. I contract my muscles, I pose. I think this helps keep the tension on the muscle. It helps bring the detail out. Obviously, I'm not doing anything for legs, so I can't use that for that. But when I practice the poses, I think you should hit everything together. There's nothing wrong with that. And I think we're gonna do another set of incline dumbbells here. You'll notice also I don't lock out on these either. Same reason as I discussed earlier, I don't like to put the tension back on my shoulder. And again, I have very, very overpowering triceps. I'm sure there's people that are saying that there's synthol on there right now, which I've gotten my whole career. No, there is not. I did sight inject my rear delts when I was competing. I thought that my rear delts were terrible. I still think that they are, and it does help, but nothing in the arms. So you can actually see from this angle some of the tears in my arms. My right bicep, I had reconstructive surgery on, tore that one really bad. And the left one, I have partial tears in that I didn't have surgery surgery on. So you can see at only 33 years of age, I've taken my share of lumps and bumps training over the years. So now I'm all about training to not get hurt anymore and be able to stay in the gym. Pose a little bit here. A little side chest. Hit some front shots. Now you can see, although I'm hitting front shots here, so I'm not concentrating as much on my back, you can see that because of my injury, on my right side, it's very hard for me to get that lat out, and it isn't out all the way. That's something that I've been working on a little bit. People ask me if I'm making a comeback. Realistically, you know, if I can't hit the poses, you know, I'm not going to get on stage. So, you know, that is not an excuse. I simply am in too much pain and too locked up to hit some of the poses the right way. Quick little ab shot, although I said I wouldn't do that until the end of the BPJ transformation. It's probably the last time you guys will see it. And now we're going to move on and finish off with some incline flies. This is another one of the exercises I really like a lot. I usually finish up my workouts with a cable crossover. But today, since I used the pec deck in with my supersets, I decided to finish off with a dumbbell move instead. I think that you could pretty much alternate the pec deck and the cable crossover. I really, really like the stretch of an incline dumbbell fly. The stretch, I think, is the most important part of this movement. You should really concentrate on the negative and getting that big stretch. Again, we're not going to show all the sets here. It's going to be boring if we do that. Got some guys taping boxes in the background. But, you know, as I said, we're doing about four working sets per exercise. And you see, you know, by the time I'm done, you'll see there the clock again. We did not even take 40 minutes to do about 25, 30 total sets. So that's the pace of move out. You'll see I'm pretty sweaty. It's taken me a while to get my stamina up to this level. Usually people hate it, but that's how I train. Hope you guys like the video. And if you want more, let me know.